Hello everyone, and welcome back to another Total War Warhammer video. This time bringing you a battle against the Vampyr Counts. Yes, after I fought off many greenskin hordes and basically drove them out of the Badlands, I turned my attention to the very annoying Vampyr Counts. And this is one of our first battles with them out in the open plains near their territory. Now, I got two armies here against, I believe, they're basically 20 stack. Now, their armies are interesting in the sense that they rely heavily on the leadership provided by their vampyr. And in this case, it's Karstein. Good old Vladdy boy. And they have really annoying flyer units, like the Vargeist. These guys are, of course, one of the regiments of renown, which I do not have access to in my current playthrough because I'm playing through an older version and would have to get rid of my save in order to get those guys. So I'm actually kind of playing it a little vanilla-y. But anyways, you can see a very large army. Rely a lot on terror, which is good for us because dwarves aren't exactly slouches in that regard. And a lot of their units are really squishy, but also extremely... You know, like, they'll have guys that cause terror, like I believe these dudes over here do. Crypt Horrors, same thing with these guys, flying Vargeist. Not a whole lot in the realm of siege equipment or long range to have to deal with on these. They do have some pretty good magic users, but again, as dwarves, kind of a natural resistance to that, so not a big deal. And in goes my artillery. Right onto their skeletons, into the main line. Where I can do the most work. I got a good line here. Lots of dwarven long beards and dwarf warriors. Really high XP. And we got a smaller reinforcing army over here. Coming from the east. Well, I guess the right flank of our army. I'm not really sure where north or south is on this thing. But as always, a good thing when you're going up against armies with high groups, large amounts of big monsters, are the bolt throwers. They almost insta-kill some of them. I mean, you get one of these bolts going through, like, one of those crypt horrors, or... does a lot of damage. So that's where you want to be focusing those guys at. As always, the big bane of dwarven existence, fast-moving cavalry and monsters like this. So you can see the two wings ready to do a flank attack over here on us. Fellbats and Black Knights. So I kind of try to... There we go. Get some, boys. So I love my Thunderers. Doesn't matter if you got armor, bro. Gonna shoot right through that. There we go. Here come the exchanges from the Quarrelers. Artillery's still incoming. The battle lines are about to close. But if you can, it's always nice to get rid of these flanking units here because they will cause mayhem in your rear lines, especially when it comes to your artillery. And as always, the door... Yeah, look, that whole unit gone, ski. That's what Thunders are all about. So I'm reforming them here in order to bring them fire on these Vargeist and these Crypt Horrors. But it's a good thing these guys are tall, because they're getting shot to pieces while they fight. I got a Rune Lord over here. These guys are great. I believe it's the Rune of Steel or the Rune of Armor. Basically gives like plus 40 armor to everybody in his area of effect, which is pretty devastating. And of course the awesome Fire Drakes, or Iron Drakes I should say, using their flame flamethrowers to get it on the enemy. which is usually terror causing, really doesn't really affect these guys too much as far as terror, unfortunately, on humans and greenskins, though. Does a great job. But unfortunately, they're going to get attacked. Let's see, I start to move these guys further out this way in order to get them to do that kind of swinging L-shaped ambush type deal. So I march them out a little further. Right flank is a pretty big mess. Luckily we got Longbeards holding it down. They always give a good buff to all the units around them with their special rule called Old Grumblers, so they kind of keep the morale up a little bit higher. But as always when dealing with the vampire accounts in particular, let's see if we can find Vlad over here. I don't even know where he's at. Taking out their leaders is actually super duper useful. There he is. Well, oftentimes if you can kill the whole army, cause the army to just start crumbling, or if you kill the leader, a lot of times they'll the whole army will just start to crumble because it's basically held together by his will. But as you can see, these guys, Vargeist, really annoying when it comes to your, attacking siege weaponry and stuff. That's basically what they're for. Crypt Horrors, same thing. They just run in and do work over your dudes. So it's always good to bring a lot of heavily armored units, freaking Iron Breakers, Hammers if you've got them, Longbeards. But remember that a lot of the damage the dwarves do is in their ranged units, so hence why I have such range-heavy armies. Used to call them gun lines on the tabletops. Overall, the battle's still pretty even. My center line, though, is not looking so hot. A lot of my siege crews are fighting in the mix there, so... These guys, you can see these thunders, are not firing because there is a lot of friendly forces in the way. So that's one another thing that would have been useful to micro them, is put them in the melee and charge them in. Yeah, that was a close defeat, and that's another Total War Warhammer battle video. Thank you for joining.